I'm Kim, and today I'm showing you my unboxing of the Fairy Loot box for the month of April. And to be totally honest, it's not really an unboxing because I already opened it, but I still wanted to show you what was inside. So yeah, I'm filming this video, and I say this in every Fairy Loot video because I hardly ever unbox it in front of the camera because I film in German and in English, so one always gets the already unboxed box. And this month I was away for a week, and my little sister opened the box to see what was inside, and so obviously when I came home and the box was already there, I looked inside and even took pictures and stuff, and so it's not really an unboxing. So obviously the box is this one I didn't show you already, so here you go in case you've never seen a Fairy Loot box. The first thing in the box, as usual, is the card with all the information on the back and the theme on the front, or the picture of the theme on the front. This month's theme is Dreams and Wishes, and as usual, I really, really like the artwork. To be totally honest, I don't really like the way she's, like, her face. I don't really like the way that's drawn, but I really like the style of drawing in general, and I really, really like this card and all the other cards. Whatever. Let's get into the stuff that was in there. So the first thing which got me really, really excited is this teacup, and it says, "To the stars who listen and the dreams that are answered." And obviously it's a quote from A Court of Mist and Fury. And I enjoyed this book so much. I enjoyed both of the books, the first and the second one, but the second one was just perfect. Or, well, obviously it wasn't perfect. There are a lot of problems, but whatever. But I absolutely loved the book. I was so happy with it. And the scene from which this quote is taken is a really, really great scene. And I love the quote. And I'm really happy to have my first bookish cup. And then the second most exciting thing is the book is this candle from Meraki Candles. And it's called Reverie. And it smells of mint marshmallows and candy floss. And it's just, I don't even want to open it because then I can't stop smelling it. It's so amazing. Like, I burned it right after I got this. I just tried it and burned it, and my husband, he was lying on the couch watching TV, and he was like, "What's that smell? It smells so good." And he usually doesn't really like candles and stuff, so good job, Meraki Candles. And I'll just show you the candle. It's white. Oh, just opening the candle just releases the smell. It's amazing. And it has, like, pink glitter everywhere. It's awesome. Awesome. And the next thing is this little pin which says Dreamers of it on it. It's from House of Wonders. And yeah, it's just really cute and glittery blue and pink. And it's a pin and it's just cute. Then we have this magnet, and it's from Fairy Loot, so there's no other, like, person behind it, just Fairy Loot, and it says, "Follow your dreams, they know the way." And the only sad thing is, my fridge isn't, like, a magnetic fridge. It has the same, like, thing as my cupboards and everything, so it blends in with my kitchen, and so I don't have nowhere to put my magnets, which I'm really sad about, because I sometimes get nice magnets and can't really use them, but I really, really like it. And I love all those, I know it's so cliche and whatnot, but I love all the dream catchers and feathers and the colors, and it's just so amazing. Okay, then the next thing is the one thing that I probably won't use, but it's still amazing, and it's this notebook by Portico, and the cup, which I forgot to mention, is by Risa Rodel. Just so you know. And it's a gemstone notebook, so there were 12 different notebooks, so one for each gemstone for each month of the year, kind of. And mine is emerald with the color green and the month of May and some chemistry, like, thing that I don't understand. And obviously it has an emerald here. I would have loved to get whatever gemstone is for the month of September, because that's my birth month. Or anyone that's blue, like a sapphire or something, because of Ravenclaw. But I got emerald, which is Slytherin, and I'm still really excited. And it's got golden edges, and it's just lined inside. And maybe you're wondering now, because maybe you know that I'm, like, a notebook person, and maybe you've seen my bullet journal videos. So why would I not use a notebook? Well, the thing is, I love making lists. I love having a notebook where everything is, like, I'm, I'm, I, I'm so happy since I found my bullet journal, and then I made my bookish bullet journal, and I'm really happy with that. But I have everything I need in those two journals, or third one because I have an actual journal, but I have everything I need in these three journals, so there's no need for me to like have another notebook for anything else. It's just it. Like, I have so many notebooks because I always keep them because I like notebooks, but I don't need them. Because why? I like everything neat and organized, so in just one or two or three journals. But I still really like it, and I'm going to keep it because it's gold. It's gold. It's shiny. I'm a niffler and I like shiny things. But let's get on with it. There's only one more thing because before we... There's only one more thing because... Why? There's only one more thing before we get to the book, and it's this tote bag. It's by Miss Fee, or Pi, or Phi, or however she's pronounced. And it says, "Madness is a matter of perspective, little dreamer." And it's from The Mime Order by Samantha Shannon, which is, I think, the second book in the Bone Season series. I'm not exactly sure. I haven't read the Bone Season yet, but I want to. It's on my TBR, so I'm really happy with this. And I really like the look of it, and you can never have enough tote bags, right? Then we have two kind of advertisement things. The first one is this little postcard for Hunted by Megan Spooner, which I really want to read. It sounds really interesting. There's nothing on the back, just a regular postcard. And my cat decided she needs to eat now, again, as in my last video. Why? Why? Well, the next thing, again, is kind of an advertisement thing. It's for Spindlefire. And I actually hoped Spindlefire was the book in this box, and it's not. So I'm kind of disappointed. I would have really liked Spindlefire. But, yeah, still, really nice. So, for the actual book bag thingy, let's see what's inside. The first one is the bookmark. So, from this box onwards, Fairy Loot will always include an exclusive Fairy Loot bookmark, which has the same print on the front as the card, as the information card, and on the back it just says Fairy Loot. And I think this is amazing because, as I said, I love the prints, and I want to keep them, and I put them on my bookshelf, but you can't really see them, and I have nowhere to hang them, and I don't know, but the bookmarks, I can actually use them to throw my glasses off of my face, for example. But I really like it. Then I feel like Santa Claus digging into my little bag here. Whatever. Ha! We have the letter from the author. Then, next, we have Fairy Scoop with all the information about the next book, a box, and whatever may be in here. Interview with the author. There you go. Everything's falling to the ground. No, it's just a Fairy Scoop, and it hasn't fallen to the ground, just to the chair that's standing next to me. So, then we have this little card with my reading buddy on the back. In case you do not know, every box has this hashtag number, but it's a different one. Well, two people get the same number. So there are a lot of different numbers, and always two people get the same number. And this other person who's got the same number as you could be your reading buddy. So you can just hashtag your Instagram picture or on Twitter with this hashtag you get in your box, and then you can find your reading buddy. And for my past two boxes, I didn't find one. For this box, I actually found my reading buddy, which is sad because I already read the book, so I can't really be her reading buddy. I'm sorry. I already told her, I'm sorry, I already read the book, but whatever. Then we have the signed author bookplate, signed by the author bookplate, whatever, you know what I mean. And the book, oh, wrong way. It's Given to the Sea by Mindy McGinnis. And as I just said, I already read the book. I got it off of NetGalley, and I read it, and I didn't like it that much. I rated it 3 stars. It was okay, but it wasn't that good. So when checking Goodreads for new releases to kind of find out which book was going to be in this box, it was like, This was the one that sounded the most likely, but I wasn't like, no, probably it's not that one. And I checked, and then there was Spindlefire, which kind of could have been the book. So I was like, oh yeah, it would be amazing if it was Spindlefire. So it's probably Spindlefire. It has to be Spindlefire. And now it's Given to the Sea. But still, I really like this one. It's a great addition to my bookshelf. I don't really mind getting books that I've already read, because I read a lot of books on ebook, and then I don't have them in my bookshelf, so I don't mind getting books that I've already read to put in my bookshelf. So that's not a problem. And yeah, I didn't like it that much, but I'm probably still going to continue with the series. And yeah, the cover, it's really shiny. I think I would have preferred it if it was matte, but whatever. And beneath the cover looks like this, and yeah, just plain and simple. I really like this, actually, when it looks like this. But still, it seems like I'm really negative with this book, which I'm not. I'm really happy I got this book, and it's going to make a great addition to my bookshelf. The only thing is, I didn't like it that much. You can't always get what you want. I mean, I liked the book that was in my first Fairy Loot box. It was Empress of a Thousand Skies. And the one from my second box, which was Strange the Dreamer, I haven't read yet. So I read 2 out of 3. That's good, I guess. I hope you'll still give me a thumbs up and subscribe, even like if you liked this book and I didn't or whatever. Leave me a comment, tell me what you think of the box, if you are subscribed to the box or not, and if you've read the book or not, or if you want to read it, what you thought about it, and just leave me a comment. Bye!